There they go. Brilliant.
And welcome back to another video. I know I need my haircuts, just ignore that. I am basically reassembling the yard for the cows now. It's October, what day is it? I think it's like the October 14th, October the 15th. It's Monday anyway. And basically the cows are going to be coming in soon. So we need to reassemble the yard from, I suppose you could say, a summer state, which is kind of things everywhere, you know, messy bales in every single shed. Then I need to bring the scraper in. I'll scrape the yard out to make it a bit more cleaner, you know. The digger over there decided to dump the contents of its engine and, well, you know, all the oil. That's getting fixed, but the scraper's behind it, so I'm gonna have to go and drive over some of those rotten bales and whatnot to get it out. These spare bales are, well, they've got their ups and their downs, but definitely they're annoying to shift. May have went a bit close to that. But. Where you really want a straight tractor, but as soon as the ring feeder comes in here, it's not enjoyable to scrape this bit with this tractor. In fact, I did put this scraper on the International once, and it was amazing at scraping. Brilliant. Sheep will have to be kicked out soon as well. It'd be nicer if I had the loader off. Be able to do a bit of a better job. Just takes time, that's all. Just takes time. Between lifting and lowering the loader and the scraper. I'm not sure what's going to happen with the International, where it's going, or if it's going to leave it there and not put cows in there just now or what, I don't know. We're just like pulling it up this kind of little strip here. Sometimes in the winter when it's rained a lot, you have to like take two scoops of this, because it's just so much. Cows are actually there at the gate for them to come in. Camera's on my head now. look a bit daft with this on, but I'll have it. Thing up here. We'll have to fall and make one hell of a bloody bang. No, I'll make it around there. Very easy to hook these feeders. Right, we'll just put that like that, and then when that falls over, bit of luck, it won't smash off the ground. So I can lower it down easily without making too much of a bang. Here we are. Get this one out first. See, oh no, I forgot they're not that heavy. Just caught some grass. There we are, a bit like a big hamster wheel. After rip that out the grass. I'm imagining this one will go. Well, I imagine this one will be the next one to go, rather. I think it should last this year anyway. Alright, that's the second feeder going in place. That's the ropey one. Try not to drop it. I'm just going to shunt it with the bucket gently over into its corner. Sorry, it's a bit of a boring vlog. I can blame the rain for it. There we are, not bad at all. Lower this one down. What am I doing? That's what I'm doing. Oh, there we are. There's another one in place. Lift up out the grass. Here we are.
that'll do it.
Right, let's go and get the cows in.
Come on.
Trailer.
Oh, come on, down off the seat.
All the dogs are bad for doing that. The cows went out this morning. See, the yard's empty now, it's a bit of silage in the ring feeders. And shed's been used now. So basically that's it. I'll go around here and show you the pit. It's not too windy. This is the silage pit here. We were taking a couple of grabs out here, one out here, or two. Yeah, that's us into the silage now. It's not too bad, I'd say. It was quite pickly. Not too dry, not too wet. I think that's all right. There's a few inches of slime on the top, but just can't really prevent that on this front bit. You can't roll it as well. So yeah, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you all for watching. Next video will be what day? Sunday or Monday morning again. Just depends what day it's. Gets uploaded on. So yeah, thank you all for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.